taken by the Indian governments, or maybe some other organizations are also involved to actually helping to develop some positive sides. Like they are keep joining the certain community people together. And as we heard about some examples and quoted earlier, that organic farmers start getting promoted here. And at this time, what we can see is very simple to understand. Like Sikkim, Uttarakhand, and other states, they have been start taking organic farming at a larger scale. So people are keep joining it, they are keep moving it. So the first slide that we have it now. As we can see, the some government data have been collected, and based on it can easily say there are around 12 states where the organic farming is continuing in a wide manner, and there are nearly 2 million hectares area roughly under these 12 states. And if you take a look on the total food production that we are getting it from the organic part, it's a total. Okay, it's not related with the domestic or maybe the export of it's total food production, organic. It is nearly around 1.35 million tons. It's a 2015-16 data. Moving on. Now let's see how the other states they start taking organic. What are the initiative points they are taking in? How they are appreciating the other people or local people to join the organic movement? Let's take the first point that is written here. Here we can see it is an example of the Karnataka state government. Karnataka state government actually have launched one new scheme, okay, organic scheme with the name of Amrit Bhumi. Okay, this state campaigning, it has been started with more than 5 lakh farmers. Okay, and it has been expected nearly 4 lakh hectares area will be covered under it. And the total estimation cost for this particular campaign to fund, it has been released around 200 crores rupees, 200 crore rupees. Now, every state they have their policy on organic farming. So the Karnataka, they have started the policy with the name of Karnataka State Policy on Organic Farming, which is under the Commissionerate of Agriculture. तो ये फाइनल हो रहा है कर्नाटक स्टेट पॉलिसी के नाम से आपकी ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग बन रही है इट्स अंडर द कमिश्नरेट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर व्हिच विल बी फाइनलाइजिंग सून नाउ कमिंग टू द वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट एग्जांपल इन इंडिया दैट वी हैव सीन इट द लॉन्चिंग पैड इफ यू कैन से ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एग्रीकल्चर इन इंडियन कंडीशन द सिक्किम टुक ओवर एंड लीड द इंडिया एंड द एंटायर स्टेट has been adapted to go for the organic. And related with this one, a resolution was passed in the state assembly at that time. And 2016 onwards, the Sikkim has been declared as an first organic state of India. Similarly, let's see what other state have the some promotions. Bihar is also moving on. Bihar started a new certification program, the new certification standards. And those
Excuse me,
standards.
sir.
हाँ बेटा बताओ.
सर विजिबल नहीं हो पा रहा है आपकी स्क्रीन पे जो लिखा है बहुत ब्लर्ड दिख रहा है
बहुत ब्लड है आप बेटा जूम कर सकते हो अपनी स्क्रीन पर क्योंकि
तब
मेरे में
भी
तो
जूम कर रहे हैं तो और ब्लर हो
हाँ
जा रहा है क्योंकि ये पिक्चर बहुत या तो आप रीड आउट कर दो एक
मैं
बार
रीड आउट ही कर रहा हूँ मेरे मेरे को सुनते भी जाओ ठीक है ना जस्ट कीप कीप लिसनिंग मी एट द सेम टाइम आप जो देख रहे हैं आप मैं जो बोल रहा हूँ ट्राई टू मैच इट ओके आई विल कीप मूविंग द फर्स्ट पॉइंट अगेन आई विल से कर्नाटक स्टेट दे हैव स्टार्टेड द ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग स्कीम द स्कीम ऑफ द नेम ऑफ द स्कीम इज अमृत भूमि एंड it has around more than 5 lakh farmers which will be like to be get benefit, and the area to be covered under this program is 4 lakh hectares. To make it successful, this government has already released more than 200 crores rupees. And to develop the policy, there is a name which has been given, Karnataka State Policy on Organic Farming, which has been under the desk of the Commissionerate of Agriculture, Karnataka. Now, coming to the second point, the Sikkim government was first of it itself in India, which took the lead, and they decided to cover or convert the whole state as an organic state. And the resolution was passed in 2015 by State Assembly. Now, and it was decided to convert the entire state by 2015. An act was declared, and 2016 onwards, Sikkim considered as the first organic state of India. Followed by Sikkim ke baad hamara dusra kaun sa? Uttarakhand. Okay, Uttarakhand is the second state. Now, moving on, the third point, if you take a look, Bihar is also have a new plan to go for the organic certification. So they are developing a draft, and that state organic standard will be considered as the, with the logo, not as a logo, but as a brand, JB, that will be the name as an organic brand. B means Bihar, Jai Bihar. That will be their organic brand to promote organic farming to all the local community and the farmers of Bihar. Moving on. Now, Madhya Pradesh also have the organic policy. The name is State Policy on Organic Farming in Madhya Pradesh. It's a very similar name. Karnataka State Policy on Organic Farming. There was it. This one is State Policy on Organic Farming in Madhya Pradesh. Now, they actually have been started the Madhya Pradesh as a Jaivik Kheti standards. So whatever the organic practices will be considered, it will go under the name of Jaivik Kheti. And they decided to have the approach of farm to fork. Farm to fork approach. ये farm to fork approach क्या होता है? नेहा है? नेहा पढ़ा लिया? नेहा, can you hear me? नेहा पढ़ा लिया?
हेलो,
हाँ, मेरा पॉइंट सुना था?
प्लीज अ वॉइस नहीं आ रही. हेलो,
अब आ रही है?
हाँ सर.
हाँ, मैंने मैंने मुझसे बोलो ना बेटा, आपको वॉइस नहीं आ रही है, कोई दिक्कत है तो मैं बताऊंगा ना. क्वेश्चन है, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फार्म टू फॉर्क अप्रोच? मध्य प्रदेश कैंपेनिंग कर रहा है ऑर्गेनिक फार्मिंग की, उनका अप्रोच है फार्म टू फॉर्क. व्हाट डू मीन?
पता नहीं.
नहीं पता? पूछ लो ना मुझसे, मुझसे पूछ लो तो हम बम बता दिया करेंगे. हम भी बैठे थे. सदफ है?
जी सर.
सदफ बताओ बेटा, फार्म टू फोर का अप्रोच क्या होता है?
सर फार्म टू फोर तो मतलब इकोनॉमिक्स का टर्म है, इकोनॉमिक्स में यूज करते हैं कि जो साइट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन से साइट ऑफ कंजम्पशन मतलब उस तक लेके जाना।
ओके एग्जैक्टली। सो ये तो ठीक है, ये बात सही है कि साइट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन से साइट ऑफ कंजम्पशन तक ले जाना है, तो इस अप्रोच में करना क्या पड़ेगा?
सर मतलब सारी जो भी प्रैक्टिसेस हो वो ऑर्गेनिक मतलब ऑर्गेनिक के लिए फार्मिंग से वो हो।
There will be a channel. The whole channel will be considered as an organic channel. That's what it means. Like from the farmers to the harvester to the processor to the distributor and the marketing agencies, they all should be considered under the same until and unless it has been reached to the consumers or the final as a final produce. That is known as farm to fork approach. Okay, thank you, Sadaf. Keep moving. Now, again, some other states. Before that, I will say, let's talk about the Pantnagar. Pantnagar also has done some recent advances in our university because Uttarakhand has been much more relies on any agriculture advances in our university also. So it has been said around 52,000 farmers and 71,000 hectare area across the state, they have been helping to promote to grow vegetables and the fruits as well. Okay, similarly if you take a look on the Kerala, the right side, if you take a look, Kerala in some of the areas, some of the districts are considered as the fully organic one. Like Wayanad. Wayanad is one of the district and Idukki. They are both hilly areas in the Kerala. Now they have been considered under the organic policies of Kerala as fully organic. Similarly, Karnataka government already has started, that was already discussed, no need to become seen. And the last point, if you take a look at the right hand side, this is the beginning in the government efforts where the declaring some panchayats as fully organic by next year and leading to the conversion of the whole state as organic in the long run. Okay, this has been considered by the Pantnagar as well as the Uttarakhand also, that we are keep looking the grassroots people to directly approach them, just to talk to them, make some clusters and working on the same. Regarding the clusters, I will discuss this one, this point later. We have our scheme. Now, this is about the Kerala initiatives which has been taken. Sorry. Now, some initiatives which says that Kerala already have one certifying agency, okay, as per the needs of the farmers, and they already developed two brands under the organic. One is Kerala Organic and another has the name Kerala Naturals. And all the campaigning has been done by these two brand names. And not only the brand they have developed, they also developed the third point, organic bazaar also. Let's say that in Thiruvananthapuram, they have organic bazaar, some eco shops in Thrissur, ek another district hai, theek hai, jisme eco shops ke naam se chal raha hai, and Kozhikode mein bhi, and Kannur mein there is a one center with the name of Jai Krishi Seva Kendram. Jai Krishi Seva Kendram in Kannur. Now, Kerala government also has moved to the self-help groups where they are encouraging especially the women to go for the organic productions of the vegetables. जी का माइक ऑन है, जरा बंद कर लो बेटा। मूविंग ऑन नेक्स्ट पॉइंट। Now, this is overall related initiatives by the Indian government. Indian government कर क्या रही है, कहाँ कौन से step उठा रही है, उससे related है. So, if we take a look, the first farming practices. If we go for the farming practices, the focus is basically to develop the organic farms or biodynamic farms. When it comes to the farmers, the government is trying to provide the agricultural credits, kisan credits, some rehab package also given to those farmers who had some damages, also as some losses, natural calamities. And in the 2008, the some of the debts of the farmers, it has been also waived off under the scheme of debt relief scheme. Now, coming to publicity stunt, how to promote. The awareness has been given through different manners like Kisan call centers, agri marketing, which has been given large coverage. And aapko pata hoga, Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana jo hai, isko Parampargat Krishi Vikas Yojana ke naam se bhi jana jata hai, jo organic farming shuru hui hai. Under the Ministry of Agriculture, Paramparagarat Krishi Vikas Yojana. Uske baare mein main discuss karunga. I'll come back to this. Okay. Now regarding the good quality seeds, how the initiatives has been taken? There is a mission with the name of TMOP, Technology Mission on Oil Seeds. Here, the government is trying to take as much as coverage of the rain-fed areas, especially which have the oilseed productions, as well as good quality seeds are start providing to the farmers related with the pulses as well as maize. Let me remind you again, organic farming movement has been started usually to promote under the rain-fed areas first. We already discussed some of the reasons behind it, why it is so easy to go ahead with the organic in India through this channel, rain-fed areas. Okay. And last point, which is related with the food security, some of the food security mission also decided, like National Food Security Mission and a National Horticulture Mission. These are the very large scale missions, which is also comes under the Ministry of Agriculture. Under this, they are trying to be helped to provide all the secure channels to those producers who are either going with the conventional farming or maybe with the organic farming. This is a wide scale. So, dono isme aate hain. Moving on. This point has not to be much more to be discussed about it, but some cooperative movements are also have been started. And some of the changes has to be required in the pesticide management bill as well as in the seed acts, because good quality hybrid seeds are to be provided. And you may heard about this one, that Uttarakhand state is coming out with one bill now, where if any distributor or the marketing agency, if they are not providing good quality seeds to the farmers, they will be paying fine or maybe will get imprisonment. That bill is already passed by the Uttarakhand too. And I guess this will change a revolutionary manner in not only in Uttarakhand but also in other states too, because nearly 60% of the crop fail is due to the poor quality of the seeds which has been dispersed or distributed by these private agencies. Moving on, this is the one of the largest program has been started by the ministry itself, Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. which is also known as organic farming movement in a simple manner. Earlier, there was no scheme by the any government, I mean at a larger level, at the national level. So this one has been brought out, and nearly 300 crore rupees have been already allocated till December 2015. What actually they are trying to do, first of all, they want to let the people have soil testing so that they will get soil health card. And by this manner, once they will have the data of all the soil health cards, they will try to promote people who start having the destroyed or degraded land areas to convert them first in the, under the organic. Because that will be the best way. And the clusters have been started developing to start this program under any state. किसी भी स्टेट में प्रोग्राम को शुरू करने के लिए क्लस्टर्स एक समूह बनाया जा रहा है जिसमें आपके 100 फार्मर्स अराउंड 100 फार्मर्स इन वन क्लस्टर्स विल बी देयर. सो इन उत्तराखंड स्टेट नियरली 500 क्लस्टर्स हैव बीन प्लांट और उसके लिए करीबन 1000 करोड़ रुपए आपके दिए गए हैं 1000 करोड़. Now look at this one. If you take a look, what do you mean by clusters? The cluster target is around 10,000. करीबन 10,000 cluster बनने हैं all over India. जिसमें से this is under the speech of the parliament, which in that this data has been provided. So I'm discussing the same. Around 7,000 clusters are already achieved till December 2015. Now in this one, the clusters they have been formed. You can see the below. Around 50 farmers, one clusters are they are preparing. But in Uttarakhand, यहाँ पर 100 farmers का एक cluster बनाया जा रहा है, which have the lands of 50 acres land. They will be promoted first to take the organic farming. Moving on. This is the next lecture that is we have it to discuss about the, some of the nutrient sources, some organic sources. क्योंकि बहुत जरूरी है. What are the possibilities to get the inputs? This is always the question. It remains with the farmer as well as with any practitioner. So before